Beloved masters, the searchlight of the soul flows in two directions, inward for illumination of the physical heart and mind, and outward to enlighten the upward spiraling path of humanity's release from the dense reality of the third/fourth dimensions. A soul-infused personality automatically develops a burning desire to share their enlightened higher truths with others. The lighted way is the bridge between the human material world and the realms of spirit. A trained, disciplined intelligence is required to clearly decipher and relay the wisdom teachings, and to proficiently and accurately transmit the higher universal concepts. Disciplined, self-directed life tendencies must be developed in order to develop intense mental clarity, along with an integrated personality that is dedicated and directed by the oversoul/higher self. The soul is neither spirit nor matter, it consists of manifested white fire seed atoms sent forth from the divine mind of our Father God into the spirit cosmic womb of our beloved Mother God, who then sends forth, via the breath of her loving Holy Spirit, all forms of cosmic matter. The awakening of self from an unconscious state of being is one of the most dramatic steps in the evolutionary process of humankind. In order to become self-conscious, you must become aware of what is happening in your personal world. You must sharpen your thinking process and learn to live in the moment, or the still point of the now as it is often called. In order to gain experience and wisdom, you must think about what you want to remember, what you wish to retain in your memory bank. Each of you, as a spark of our Father/Mother God and the Supreme Creator, has a personal wheel of creation, your own flower of life that you must learn to use again in order to become a true co-creator on the earthly plane. We ask you to envision this horizontal pattern you have created with your sacred breath as your personal wheel of creation. You draw forth the life/light of creation, via your personal column of light and through the back portal of your sacred heart, which will always consist of the appropriate frequency patterns for your present state of evolvement. Within these spheres will be the virtues, qualities, and attributes of God consciousness you are seeking to incorporate, which will result in perfecting and magnifying your abilities to create anything you desire, as long as it is for the greatest good of all. Have you wondered why, several years ago, we instructed you to breathe in light and breathe out love when you go into the world pyramid with the intention of radiating love/light to humanity and the world? When you breathe in light, you are breathing adamantine particles into your sacred heart. When you breathe out unconditional love, the adamantine particles of pure God essence are empowered or ignited by your loving intentions so that they may be used for the greatest good. You are the receptacle for these God particles and your love is the activator. Envision this, during meditation or your quiet time, take 12 full infinity breaths, and after the 12th one, pull in your abdomen and hold your breath for a moment or two. Now, as you take the next, or 13th, breath, see it flowing forth from your solar power center, sacred heart core, into the front of your body. The infinity pattern is now in a horizontal configuration instead of vertical. On either the out-breath or the in-breath, whichever one is most comfortable for you, the first flat loop extends outward in front of your body, and on the next breath, the second loop extends from the back of your body, completing the infinity sign. Breathe in and out 6 infinity signs, and as you do so, they will automatically create a pattern of 12 loops that completely surround you like the petals of a flower. As you breathe out the last loop, again, hold your breath for a moment before returning to normal breathing. Then, breathe in and out consciously as you envision the essence of creation flowing forth from you out into the world. Also, envision spirals of light connecting you to the world pyramid, the world server pyramid, and the multiple pyramids that you have created in the higher dimensions, thereby sharing your particles of love/light with the world, as well as fueling your visions with the pure life force substance of all creation. As you become more proficient as co-creators on the earthly plane, you will learn to constantly monitor your energy patterns and seek to upgrade them. You must strive for sustained harmony and refined godly expression. Your goal is to liberate the power of the sacred fire, which has lain dormant for many thousands of years, so that you may direct and focus your energy into the areas of your life you wish to change. By establishing and constantly upgrading your creator wheel of life, you are planting the seeds of focused change, and you are supplying the sacred fire of creation needed to manifest what you have envisioned. When you can do this proficiently, Your personal world will become a wonderland, and you will become a beacon of light for all to see. We have asked our messenger to give you an overview of the creation of your personal flower of life creator wheel, as well as to help you understand what a wondrous gift it is to humanity. Without an activated personal 12-ray creator wheel, you will never gain the ability to become a masterful co-creator on the physical plane of existence. The creation and progression of our personal power of life 12-ray creator wheel in many of our ancient past life experiences, as we sank into the third and lower fourth dimensional densities, we were functioning in our animal/human nature, and we had only two flower of life petals infinity signs to work with, the first, second and third dimension of frequencies. The first, second and third chakra, **first/root chakra, survival, second and third **focus on the physical body **scarcity/abundance **security **second/navel/lower abdomen chakra, ego desires **pleasure **sexual/passionate love **tolerance **third/solar plexus chakra, personal power **emotional center **mastery of desire **self-control **the two infinity signs, which created four petals, were located within and radiated from our second chakra. One petal was positioned outward, in front of us into the future, which we were creating with our thoughts, actions, and deeds. The second petal was projected from our back into the frequency patterns of our past. The third and fourth petals extended outward from each side, the same as if you were to extend your arms outward, thus forming the originally designed column of light and shadow, what has been called the middle path. We now live in a broad spectrum world of duality and polarity influenced by our DNA, our ancestral lineage, and the astrological overlay we brought forward to experience in each lifetime. As we began to access some of the higher frequency vibrational patterns of the refined, more harmonious third/fourth dimensional frequencies, we began the process of creating our human/human nature. During this process, we added two more infinity patterns to our flower of life creator wheel, which made a total of eight petals. Our flower of life creator wheel moved up into the third/solar plexus chakra. During this phase, our major life force energy radiated forth from the solar plexus. Higher third and fourth dimensional frequencies. The fourth and fifth chakras, **fourth/heart chakra, life force **spiritual power center **sacred heart chamber, where our soul self spark of divinity resides for this lifetime **herein is the threefold flame and vesica piscis sacred symbol, which contains our sacred white fire god seed Adam **fifth/throat chakra, communication **self-expression **spiritual discernment **part of our spiritual power center **the additional four petals containing the attributes, qualities and virtues of these two added infinity signs created a flower of life pattern with eight petals. We began the process of slowly balancing and harmonizing the seven chakras of soul consciousness for this solar system via the ancient teachings of the past, and from the new influx of teachings from the higher realms. As we learned to listen to the whisperings of our soul self, we were introduced to the universal laws of manifestation. Over time, we gradually began to develop our self-awareness, and we eventually gained the wisdom to understand the importance of the now moment or the power of the still point. This was a vital step in the awakening process so that we could, once again, begin to use the tools of manifestation as conscious co-creators. During this final stage/cycle of our ascension process for this round of evolution for humanity, we are endeavoring to become spiritual/human beings. The last two infinity signs, with four more petals, complete our personal flower of life **12-ray creator wheel for this particular cycle. Our completed 12-ray creator wheel moved up into the high heart area of the fourth/heart chakra. By this time the portals to our sacred heart and sacred mind are open. The sacred heart itself is located a little higher than the physical heart, and is positioned toward the back of the body, resting against our rod of light, which runs along the spinal column. This rod of power is gradually activated as we open the seven seals to higher consciousness and connect with the oversoul/higher self that resides in the eighth chakra, our soul star. Higher fourth and lower fifth dimensional frequencies. The sixth and seventh chakras, **sixth/brow/third eye chakra, intuition asterisk inspired insight asterisk clairvoyance asterisk perception beyond duality asterisk asterisk seventh slash crown chakra, spiritual will asterisk inspiration asterisk divine wisdom asterisk beginning of unity consciousness asterisk we are beginning to see clearly that Archangel Michael is giving us the tools we need to assist us in our ascension process in a step-by-step manner. These techniques can be used in a haphazard manner with minimal success, however, if we wish to make steady progress in our efforts to achieve self-mastery, we should learn and integrate these techniques in the order they have been given. There is a reason for this, and it will become apparent as you master each technique and begin to see the positive results in your life. As you refine your resonance, you are gradually becoming multidimensional, which means that you are tapping into the frequency patterns of several dimensions at once. Forever love and angel blessings, Rana asterisk Archangel Michael beloved ones, in order to make room for the refined frequencies of the multiple levels of the higher fourth and fifth dimensions, there must be a clearing slash cleansing process. Via the lessons and instructions we have given you over the years, we are endeavoring to give you the knowledge needed to traverse the path of ascension with ease and grace, however, you must assume the responsibility for your return to personal self-mastery. We are standing by to assist you as you reclaim your rightful status as a spiritual being on a divine mission for our Mother slash Father God. We salute your bravery. You are dearly loved. I am Archangel Michael.